by his omnipotency. Because he is the almighty personality of Godhead, eternal and unlimited. He is the ultimate goal of life, and by worshiping him, one can end the cause of conditioned state of existence.
एवं सचित्ते सतैव सिद्ध्या आत्मा प्रियो अर्थ भगवान अनंता तां निर्वितो नियतार्थ भजेता संसार हेतु उपरमश्च यत्र। सो लास्ट नाइट वी डिस्कस्ड दैट व्हाई वन शुड बॉदर अबाउट हिज maintenance and go to beg from a person who is very proud of his wealth. He can arrange his own living condition. See, living condition is ahara nidra bhaya maithuna. So far one is in the renounced sort of life, so he should first of all renounce the sex life and the state of fearfulness. That is renounced. Just like here there are many brahmacharis, sannyasis. They are supposed to be renounced order, especially the sannyasi. And manaprastha, brahmachari, renounce, the first renunciation is to renounce sense gratification. Therefore, the person in renounced order is called Sami. Sami means master. Or Goswami. So, go means senses, and Sami means master. One who has become master of his senses, he is Goswami or Sami. Otherwise, if one is servant of his senses, how he can be Sami or Goswami? Every word has got meaning. So one has to renounce, this is material life. Material life means everyone is engaged for sense gratification. And that is taken as the advancement of civilization. The same sense gratification in different way, same intoxication, same meat eating, same sex life. Either go to club or naked club or this club, that means the practice is the same. Puna puna charvita charvananam. Repetition of chewing the chewed. This is material life. So, renounced order means to stop, not stop, at least control sense gratification. That is renounced. And without being in renounced order, you cannot go to the spiritual world. Just like if your hand is there, you have got something which is not very good within your hand, and if you want to take something better, so you have to throw it away and take it. The better one. You cannot keep the both things. That is not possible. Therefore, what is the difference between material life and spiritual life? Material life means simply full of problems. Every step, padanga padanga jada vipadanga, simply dangerous. We are riding very nicely, comfortably in a Cadillac car or Vector car, but we are riding on danger, that's all. We are driving, any moment the car may be smashed, especially in your country. Any moment. So shall I sit down at home? No. At home also, there may be so many dangers. We are in dangers. Simply, we are trying to counteract it. That is called advancement of civilization. The animals, they depend on nature's protection, but we are human beings, we are utilizing our higher consciousness, higher intelligence, the same thing. The Russia is manufacturing what is called weapon, the atom bomb, nuclear, yes. And America is also trying to. And the cat and dog, they are trying to protect by their nails and teeth. So the real question is defense. So the defense is, it is not that because we have got better life than the cats and dogs, we haven't got to defend. We have to defend. This is, but in a better way, not better way, after all we have to die. So anyway, we think that is a better way of defense. So material life means only busy in four things: how to eat, how to sleep, and how to have nice sex, and how to defend. Ahara nidra bhayam aithanancha shamannametat pasubhi narana. But these things are not solving our problems. That we do not understand. The problems are there. Not that we Indians have come to America to see that very rich nation, whether they have solved their problems. No, there are problems. More problems than India. India may have only one problem, that there is, actually there is no, but we are advertised that Indians are starving. But I have not seen anyone starving. Anyway, so the problem is there. The material life means problem. And if you want to solve the problems, then here is the prescription given. Hastang nivita niyatartha bhajita. Tang means the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Then the question may be, now you have asked me to give up all endeavor for maintaining yourself, Sukadeva Goswami, you have prescribed that for your food you just wait under a tree and he will give you some fruits, you can eat. For water, you go to the river and drink as much water as you like. Then, before the verse, he said, for sleeping, there is very nice mattress in the grass. I require a pillow. Now you have got natural pillow, this. You have got your hand. You lie down. Sahara nidra vayamaitunancha. But if you want to advance in spiritual life, simply you have to give up the sense gratification, and the essence of sense gratification is sex life. Otherwise, there is full arrangement for your eating, sleeping, compartment, apartment, everything is there. Temple also there you have got. Where is the temple? I want to worship God. Where is church? Where is temple? If I live at the cave, then I have to find out another means to go to the temple. Therefore, Sukadeva Goswami advises, no, evam sacitte sataiva siddha. Here within the core of your heart, the Lord is there. You sit down anywhere, in the cave, in the jungle, or anywhere, If you like, you can find out the Lord is there within your heart. Ishara sarabhutanam lindesi arjuna tishtati. Krishna says that the Supreme Lord, that means He is situated in everyone's heart. If we are sincere, we means these living entities. We are also living within this body. Asmin dehi, dehi nasu, dehi na asmin dehi. We are not this body. I am, you are, we are also situated within this body. And Krishna is also situated within this body. Ishara sarva-bhutanam riddhesi. It is not that he is situated in the heart of the Hindus and not of the others. No. Everyone, sarva-bhutanam, he is situated even in the heart of cats and dogs and tigers and others. Everyone. That is Ishara. Ishara sarva-bhutanam riddhesi. This verse we have repeatedly discussed, it is very, very important that this body is just like a motor car, jantra. Maya, Brahman, Sarvabhutani, jantra, Ruhani, Maya. Maya, through the agency of Maya, material energy, this vehicle, machine has been given to me. Why? Because I wanted to wander throughout the universe, just like they are going to the moon planet. So everyone has got this is called philosophical ideas. Everyone, every human being, if he is at all human being, he considers, that is philosophical mind, he considers, oh, there are so many stars, well, what they are doing, how many men are there, whether there is motor car, whether there is hill, ocean, these questions automatically come to an intelligent man. That is the beginning of philosophy. Natural. So actually, that is a fact. We are traveling all over the universe. Not only that we have come to this planet, we have traveled many other planets. Otherwise, how Krishna says, Brahman, wandering, sarva-bhutani, all living entities, either in the higher planetary system or this lower planetary system, and how he is traveling, jantra-rani, this jantra, this body. He is giving body. Now if I want to go to the moon planet and other higher planet, yes, you'll get. But not this jantra, your so-called tiny Sputnik. No. You have to take the jantra, the car, the vehicle from Krishna. He'll give you, if you want, if you're serious, that if you want to go to the moon planet, then you pray to Krishna that give me a jantra or a machine, I can go to the moon planet. Then you can go. Otherwise, you unnecessarily spend money and try to go somewhere and bring some dust and you say, now we are triumphant. That's all. But if you want to go there seriously, then you have to prepare yourself in this life. Pray to the Supreme Lord who has created all this moon and sun and other and this planet, and He will make you befitting, qualified to go there. You cannot go to the sun planet. It is very, very hot, high temperature. Similarly, it is very, very cold in the moon planet. So how you can go with this body? This body means this machine. Then you have to accept another machine. That is the process. That is the process. That is stated in the Bhagavad Gita. Janti deva vrata devan. Pitrin janti pitri vrata. Bhute ja janti bhutani. Majjanino pi janti mam. Everything is clearly stated there. That if you want to go to the heavenly planets or higher planetary system, they are in front of you. You can see them, that the sun planet is there, but you are so unqualified, you cannot go there. But the thing is there, it is not fictitious. The temperature here, the Shastra description, Yat-chakshuri su-savita sakala-grahana. Savita means the sun, he is the eye of all the planets. Because without sun sign you cannot see. You are very much proud of your eyes. But as soon as there is no sun, then you are blind. Therefore, Yat-chakshuri su-savita sakala-grahana. All the planets, unless there is sunrise, you cannot see. And the sun planet is there in front of you. Every morning you are getting the sun sign. Why don't you go there? Go, you have got nice 747. That you cannot. Then you have to pray. Ishvara, Krishna is within your heart, and if you fervently pray, he is very kind. Therefore, he gives you different types of vehicle. Brahman sarva-bhutani jantra-rurani maya. Brahman means making him wandering in every planet, in every species of life. Sarva-bhutani, all species of life. There are different types of birds, different types of beasts, different types of human beings. This is called vichitra, varieties. God's creation is varieties. So, if you want to go somewhere within this material world or beyond this material world, beyond this material, parastasmātu bhāva anya bhaktā bhaktyā sanātana. Krishna giving is the information that there is another material as nature, that is spiritual nature. Just like we have got this experience, although we could not go anywhere, but we see, or studying geography, that there are many, many hundred thousands and millions of planets. Similarly, there is another nature. There are also similarly the same, not only same, it is three times more than in this material world. This is only God's one part of creation. Ekamshena sthitu jagat. Athava bahunaitena kingyatena tavarjana vishtabha aham idam kristam ekamshena sthitu jagat. When Krishna wanted to know, Arjuna wanted to know from Krishna how much your potency is extended, how you are working, I want to know. Because he is inquisitive, Brahma-jignasa, he is trying to understand what is God. And God is personally replying. So he has stated in that chapter that I am this amongst this. Then he summarizes that how much I shall say, just try to understand me, my potency. That this material world, there are innumerable universes, and in each universe there are innumerable planets. I want in every one of them, Vishtabha, Aham, Idam, Krishnam, all of them, and I maintain them. Just like Krishna is situated in everyone's heart, then similarly Krishna is situated in everything, even within the atom. That is Krishna. We want to imitate Krishna, but if we are asked that he enter into the atom, that I cannot do. No. Krishna, God means he can become that the greater than the greatest. We can conceive of the greatest, the universe. So not only this universe, but many millions of universes, they are being created from the holes of his bodily hair. Jashaika nishasita kala mathavalamba jivanti loma bilaja jagadanna natha. That is God. From the, we have got many millions of holes on our body. And God has God, Mahavishnu, and from that hole, universes are coming up continually, breathing. Jashaika nishasita kala. So you must have, what is the conception of God? Greater than the greatest and smaller than the smallest. That is God. He can produce these big, big universes simply by breathing. And again, we do not know how many atoms are there in each universe. He can enter in each at home. Annantarasthang paramanuchayantarasthang ekappasaurachayatam jagadannakoti jachaktirasthi jagadannachayajadantam annantarasthang paramanuchayantarasthang govindamadipurisam tamangvaja. This is the conception of God. So here the proposal is that we are suffering in this material world. We are simply thinking that in future we shall be happy if I do like this. But before that future comes, we become punished. This is our position. Not only once, but many times, still I have happened. Just like the so-called scientist, millions of years gap, and then this will be happening, this will be happening. No, these are all nonsense. Then how your age is 50 or 60 years, how you are consuming of millions of years? Your 50, 60 years of age will be millions time finished before you realize the truth. But the so-called scientists, they are thinking, no, this 50, 60 years is a large extent of span of life. In that way, you cannot understand. That is not possible. Chivangavichinnan, if you speculate in this foolish way for Chirang, eternally, still you cannot understand. Chivangavichinnan. Athapiti deva padam vijadnam prasadali shanu grihitai vahi janati tattam bhagavat mahimna. Nachanayi kopi chirang vichinnan. Chirang means eternally if you speculate to understand God by your teeny brain and limited sense perception, it will be not. To take the prescription of this shastra, if you want, the first is that you must give a material attachment. Material attachment, so long I will be attracted by material things. Krishna will give me a relative body. Tatha dehandra prapti. If we want this temporary material enjoyment, then according to the body, there is enjoyment. In the ant's life, there is also the same thing, eating, sleeping, sex, and defense. And in the Lord Indra's, or the King Indra, the heavenly king, he has all the same propensity, eating, sleeping, mating, and defense. So if you go to the moon planet, or sun planet, or the topmost place, wherever you go, the four things will follow. Eating, sleeping, mating, defense, and birth, death, old age, and disease. So long we shall remain in this material world. I may be Lord Indra, Lord Brahma, or President of America, or this or that. You cannot avoid these four things. That is material existence. That is the point But if you want to solve the problem, then this is the process given, the nimitta. Anna-vilasita-sunnam. Don't aspire for material enjoyment. Enjoyment is there. Don't think that if I stop my material enjoyment, then my life of enjoyment is finished. No, it is not finished. Just like a diseased man, he is also eating, he is also sleeping, he is also having other duties. But that he is eating, sleeping, and a healthy man's eating, sleeping is not the same thing. Similarly, our material enjoyment, the eating, sleeping, mating, defense, that is with full of dangers. We cannot enjoy it without any hindrance. There are so many hindrances. So if we want that uninterrupted happiness, happiness is there. Just like a diseased man, he is also eating, and the healthy man is eating, but he is having bitter taste. A man with jaundice, if you give him sugar candy, his taste is bitter. That's a fact. But the same person who is cured from the jaundice disease, he tastes it very sweet. Similarly, in the material condition of life, there are so many inabilities. We cannot enjoy life fully. If you want full enjoyment of life, then you must come to the spiritual platform. Dukkhalarma sahasatam. This material world has been described in the Bhagavad Gita that this is dukkhalam. It is the place of miseries. Then if you say, now I have made arrangement, I have got now nice bank balance, my wife is very nice, my children are also very nice, so I don't mind, I shall remain in the material world. Krishna says, asāsatam. No, sir, you cannot live here. You will be kicked out. Dukkhāram asāsatam. If you agree to stay here in this miserable condition of life, that is also not allowed. No permanent settlement. Tathā dehāntara prāpti. So these problems, where is the scientist? They are discussing about this problem. But the problems are there. Who wants to give up whatever family he has got? Everyone has got family. But nobody wants to give up his family. But he, by force he is taken up. The man is crying, I am now going, I am now dying. What will happen to my wife, my children? He is forced. He must get out. So this is the problem. So where is the solution of the problem? There is no solution of the problem. If you want solution of the problem, then Krishna says, Mārapetta kauntiya dukkhānava sāsatam nābhivanti mahātmāna samsiddhīṁ paramāṅgatā. If one comes to me, Mārapetta, then he hasn't got come to again in this material world full of miseries. So yes, Sukadeva Goswami is suggesting that you become devotee. Your all problems will be solved.